So welcome back to Orchid House. I'm Olivier in Fort Lauderdale, and today I wanted to talk about good old hydrogen peroxide. The most obvious use for it is whenever I cut something, I spray that to avoid infection, and then on top of that I pour some ground cinnamon on top of it because this is antifungal. It's an antibacterial stuff, so I mean whenever I see something that I don't like on a leaf, my first instinct is to try and spray this and see what happens. You know, little yellow spots, sunken spots and everything, and that often helps. Now, the reason I'm doing the video is to talk about something a little bit different, is how I prevent rot from developing on mostly Catasetums. So this Catasetum has been repotted, it's ready for the new year. You see it already has a new growth, nice new roots, but the problem is here, so it had a bit of a sunburn. And as you can tell, I mean, it's always best to try and leave. I mean, the temptation is strong to make these bare bulbs pretty and remove all that stuff, but old leaves protect against sunburn. Now, this one I discovered very quickly, and so I sprayed peroxide three times in a row within 2 or 3 days apart. And it's no longer, it's not soft. I mean, this is hard, and I'm pretty sure it's good to go. Now, this is going to remain ugly, but at least the bulb is not going to rot. If I had not noticed, that bulb just would slowly disintegrate, start rotting, and it would be bad. Another example, this is actually it's kind of a division. So I bought a plant that I think is very attractive. It's a Catasetum fimbriatum variety morenianum. So instead of being yellow-green, it's a very dark red-brown color. It has a very, very attractive fragrance. And so I have the mother plant. It has two nice bulbs, and this one was a third bulb that was growing inside the medium. And when I tried to repot it, I realized that this was rotting, and I mean, this is part of it is gone really. So I could have thrown it away. I mean, I'm not sure if this is going to help a lot, but I sprayed peroxide day after day for a few days, and I poured cinnamon on top of it, and the result is that now this is bone dry, the rots stopped spreading, and this is, I salvaged this. Now, whether or not it's going to do anything is anybody's guess. I expect to have a little growth somewhere. This is still very plump, so maybe I'll be able to generate a new plant and a good division from this, or maybe not. I mean, if it wasn't a very important plant for me, I probably wouldn't worry about it, but since it is, I'm giving it a try. And this is from years ago, so it's a Catasetum hat trick. And that year, I mean, I had two bad surprises. First of all, a sunburn here, and then this one started cracking right in the middle. And again, I used peroxide, and the result is that I managed to stabilize it, and it became all dry, stopped the rot. And since then, I mean, this is a division. I made a division from this. Last year's growth is very strong, very sturdy, so I saved this plant. This is not very pretty. Down the road, I'm going to remove it, but at least I saved the plant. And you see, this is what I was talking about. It's best not to clean it, leave it, because this is going to prevent sunburn. This is protective. So this is all regarding Catasetums. If you look at my videos, you know I have a bunch of those guys, but I have something else here, and honestly here I don't really have an explanation for it, but so far it worked. So this is called an Oncidium, used to be called an Oncidium crispum. Today it's a mouthful, it's Gomesa imperatoris-maximilliani or something like that. It's beautiful flower. I mean, it's not easy to grow here in South Florida, it's a little warm for it. But I managed to bloom it twice last year. These blooms are gorgeous. I mean, it's a big brown Oncidium type of flower with an absolutely fantastic sweet honey fragrance. I really love it. Not easy to grow, came rest time. I mean, I let it dry because they don't like it in the wild. They really grow dry for a while. But then I started seeing new roots and I started spraying again, spraying some water, and it rotted, started rotting here. So I was desperate because, as you can tell, the rest of the plant is not very strong. And so I really sprayed peroxide with the idea that I didn't want, I could have cut it off, but I gave it a chance. But I'm still hoping that these older bulbs might generate a growth. They sometimes do. But the wonder about it all is that I sprayed peroxide regularly, and this now is stabilized. It no longer, this has been over a month and a half that this rot quit spreading. I did not know it was possible. I'm not sure it's going to save the day. We'll see. But this is dry now. It doesn't rot anymore. And the most miraculous thing happened. There's a new growth here. I'm pretty sure this is actually a new flower. So whether or not I'm going to save the plant, I don't know. But again, this is one that that's very dear to my heart. So I gave it a try. And peroxide maybe saved the day. I mean, I didn't know you could halt the rot halfway when the bulb started rotting, and again maybe eventually it will die, I don't know, but right now I have this, and this gives me hope. So again, like maybe less common uses of peroxide, but that thing can save the day for plants that are very dear to you. Thank you so much and have a great day. Bye bye.